into a floaty expressive flow. So I want you to really feel into the postures, kind of move with your breath. So as you inhale, elongating into the posture, and as you exhale, stretching deeper and deeper into the pose. We're going to start with a little standing meditation, but we're going to start to feel that floaty movement energy from the start. So we'll all start with our feet hip width distance apart, and we'll just close our eyes and just listen to my voice, and I'll guide you through. And we're just going to start to move our hips from side to side. And then maybe bringing in the arms, just moving them from left to right. And then maybe bringing them all the way up to the sky. And then just letting them fall down. And just keep doing this in your own pace, just feeling whatever movement feels right for you today. Just starting to build up some energy inside the body. You can make the movements as big or as small as you like. Kind of move like you're floating through water, I suppose. Bringing your attention to your breath. Maybe rolling the shoulders. And we'll all just bring our hands up one last time. And then bring them back down. Maybe opening up the heart a little bit as we bring our hands to heart center. Amazing. Now we're going to come to the top of our mats. Toes together, heels slightly apart. One big deep inhale and raise our arms up to the sky. And exhale, forward folds. We're just going to separate our feet to hip width distance apart, clasping each elbow with the other hand. And again, just finding movement into this forward fold. Maybe letting the hands fall all the way down to the mat and just sway from side to side. Maybe bringing the arms up overhead, clasping them together and opening up the back body. Bending into the left and the right knee. Just getting into all those little muscles in the backs of the legs. And now come to stillness. Bring our hands to the mat. Bring our heart upwards in front of us into a halfway lift as we exhale one last time. Now we're going to step our right foot back and our left foot, and we're all going to meet in a plank pose. I want you all to be strong and steady here for a moment before we start to move between downward dog and plank. We can start to shift our body weight over the hands as if we're coming down into chaturanga and then back again. And just feeling the difference of where the weight is and what different muscles start to work as you rock forward and backwards. Now rocking forward one last time, then we're going to tuck the toes under and push up into a downward facing dog. Now we're going to roll over the toes and come forward into a plank position. And then we're going to roll back to downward facing dog. And forward again to plank. And one last time back to downward facing dog.
and forward into a plank. Now we're all going to lower our knees to the floor, untuck the toes, bring our chest to the floor, and then we're going to curl under into a cobra. Now we're going to look over our left shoulder, and looking over the right shoulder. Come back to centre. Now we're going to bring our hands out just in front of us, and we're going to start to feel this flowy movement again. So we're going to push up into a high cobra and then roll down. You want to really feel the waves roll through your spine as you do this. Just starting to open up through each vertebra throughout the spine. Now we're going to bring our hands to our chest, we're going to tuck the toes back under and push all the way back to our downward facing dog. Just going to take off my socks here. Maybe walking the dog, so bending the left knee and then the right knee, and again the left and the right. Now what we're going to do here is we're all going to lift our right leg all the way up to the sky. First of all, keeping the hips square, flexing that foot, and then we'll all bend that top knee, maybe coming up onto the toes of the left foot to get a deeper opening through the hip. Now we're all going to do that, we're going to push our weight forward into our hands. Just like we were playing with the weight distribution in plank, we're going to bring our weight forward and cross our right knee over to our left elbow and hold and push all the way back into three-leg dog. Bending the knee again, this time we're going to bring our right knee all the way through and under our left arm. So we bring it to the elbow. Then we lift up the left hand and let the left leg come through, the right leg come through. Now here we can find those flowy movements again. Just feeling into whatever your body's asking for right now. It doesn't have to look like mine does. It can look however you please. Bending into the knees and opening up through the body. One last breath. And then bringing that left hand back to the foot, back to the mat. Come back up into a three-leg dog. Now we're going to put all our weight into our left hand and our left foot, and we're going to twist round and come into a side plank. You can have your left knee down for extra support as a modification. And we're just going to sweep our hand forward and around, and one more time forward and around. This time we're going to lift up our right leg, and we really need to power, we want it to move with intention here. So slowly step into a low lunge. You might need to use your hand to assist your foot to the top of the mat, and that's absolutely fine. It will just get easier every time you do this practice. Now we're going to just place our foot, a knee down, come up into a low lunge. So arms up into the sky. And again, we're gonna find this flowy movement. So we're gonna sweep our hands forward and up to the sky. And forward, up to the sky. And one last time, forward and up. And now we're gonna bring our hands and put them on the inside of our right foot, coming into a lizard pose. We can either stay here, or we can tuck the left toes under, open up that right arm, and start to feel into this movement like we were doing with Star earlier. So just making whatever movement you feel like doing. So maybe sweeping the arm as far forward as you can, and then sweeping it as far back, maybe coming onto the outside edge of the right foot. Just really feeling into your body, getting into all those muscles that often get rejected. And then bringing that right hand to meet the left, stepping the right foot back to meet the left into a plank. And then we'll bring our knees to the chest, our chin to the chest, untuck the toes, come to a cobra. Now coming back and pushing back to a downward facing dog. And now we're just going to flow through downward facing dog and upward facing dog. So we're going to keep our toes as they are, and we're just going to bring our weight forward, sink our hips down to the mat, and look up. And then push back. And then come forward, upward facing dog. And push back, downward facing dog. Amazing. Now we need to do that whole sequence on the other side. I'm just going to take off my jumper. So we'll come back to a downward facing dog. This time lifting our left leg all the way up into the air. Remember keeping the hips square, flexing the toes, and then maybe opening the hip and bending the knee. Trying to keep the arms square throughout this. Then again, we're going to bring our left knee through to our chest and touch the right elbow and hold. And then fly it back to three-leg dog. This time we're going to bring it through to that star position. So remember bringing the knee to the chest, placing it on the outside of the right hand. So bring knee to chest, foot to the outside of the right hand, open up the right hand into the sky, and then again just feeling into this pose. And then we're going to bring this left leg to the front of the mat now into a low lunge. So we want to move with intention, so slowly, 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 maybe using the hand as a self-adjust to help bring that foot to the front of the mat. Placing the right knee to the floor and bringing our arms up to the sky into a low lunge. Now finding this sweeping action, so sweeping the hands to the front of the mat and behind, and then to the front, and behind, and one last time, to the front, and behind. Now we're going to place our hands to the inside of the left foot, walk our left foot to the outside edge of the mat, coming into lizard pose here. Again, either staying here in this variation, or tucking the right toes under, pushing up through the right hand and lifting the left hand up to the sky. Again, taking any movement you'd like here, so maybe reaching all the way forward and then opening all the way to the back and then reaching forward. Just feeling into all those muscles, or just staying still, whatever you like. like to do today. Bringing that left hand to the mat, bringing the left foot to meet the right into a plank. And this time we'll do a chaturanga. So remember, keeping the arms tucked in and lowering to the ground. Coming to an upward facing dog or a cobra. And then we'll all meet in a downward facing dog for one breath before coming down to a child's pose. So we want our knees to be facing the outside edges of the mat, and then just letting our bums sit down on our heels, and then lowering our chest down to the mat. Just resting here for a couple of breaths. When you're ready, we're going to tuck our hands, put our hands firmly down to the mat, untuck our toes and push up to our downward facing dog. And then we're all just going to tiptoe our feet to meet our hands as slowly as possible. And then lowering up to standing, head and neck coming up. Amazing. Now we're going to do a sun salutation B variation. So we're going to all bring our hands up to the sky, so toes together, heels slightly apart, inhale, hands up, and then we're going to come to chair pose. So we want everyone to have their hands up in this mudra, bring them up to the sky, and we're just going to squat our hips down into chair pose. We're going to wiggle our hips here. This, I love doing this variation as it takes my mind off the actual posture, because I think it's one of my worst, and it also keeps us in our floaty theme. And now we're all going to put our weight into our left leg, lift the right leg up, step back into a high lunge, opening up the arms here, and then again we're going to sweep our arms forward three times. So one, two, one last time, and then we're going to open up into a warrior two pose. So making sure our legs are in one straight line, our left toes are pointing forward, opening our arms over and gazing over our front hands. Now we're going to sweep forward and reverse our warrior, letting the hand fall down the back leg wherever it lands. And now sweeping forward, placing our left hand, our left elbow on our left knee, and sweeping that arm the left arm over. And then we'll reverse. And side angle. One last time, reverse. Side angle. Flip the back toes under, come to a low lunge. Now we're going to swing our left leg and place it on top of our right foot. So we're going to swivel onto the outside edge of the right foot, pick up the left foot, place it on the right, come up to a side plank. Then again, we're going to lift up that left leg and with control, step it to the front of the mat, putting your hands on the inside of the left foot and coming into a lizard. This time, if it's in your practice, you can bring your elbows to the floor and coming into a low lizard. Now we're going to tuck the hands under. We're going to bring the left foot to meet the right into a plank. And then again, we're just going to wave back to a downward facing dog. Wave forward to plank one more time. and then back to a downward facing dog. And then we're all going to bend our knees, jump to the top of the mat, come to halfway lift, forward fold, and then bring our hands up above our heads. Amazing. Right, now we've got the other side to do. So again, we're going to squat down into our chair position, wiggle our hips round to the left and to the right. And then we're going to put all our weight in our right leg, lift up our left and step back
into a warrior two pose. Now we're going to lean forward and come into our reverse warrior, letting the hand fall down the back leg and then sweeping forward, right elbow on right knee, left arm up and over our heads. Into side angle pose, and then reverse, and side angle. One last time, reverse, and side angle.
Placing our hands on the floor, put the back knee on the floor. And bring our hands up to the sky into a low lunge. Again, we're going to sweep the arms forward and back. Two more times. Forward and back. And last time. Forward and back. Now placing our hands on the inside of the right foot. Into our lizard. If it's accessible to us today, then coming down to our forearms. Pushing back up onto our hands, bringing our right foot to meet the left foot into a plank, and hold here, and then push back to a downward facing dog. And we're all going to bend our knees here and jump to the top of the mat, and then come up to standing, and hands to heart centre. So now we're going to do a balancing mandala flow. So that just means we reverse it halfway through. So it's a full circle sequence. So we're going to place all our weight into our left foot first and just bring our right knee up to the sky with our arms as well. Flexing the foot. Now we're going to float back into a dancer pose. So we're going to use our body to counterbalance here. So as we lean our chest forward, our knee is going to go back. So we're going to shift the weight, and then we're going to bring our right hand round to the inside of the right ankle and push up into that hand into a dancer's pose. The harder you push into that back hand, the deeper you'll be able to get into the posture. And it will be easier to balance. Now we're going to gently let go without flinging it. Straighten the back leg and bring our right hand out in front into a warrior three. Bring your hands to heart center if you want to make it a little bit easier. Now all bringing our hands to heart center, and we're going to lower our back knee behind our left foot. So you can pause and watch this through first time if you'd like to, just so you get the idea. So we're going to bend through the left leg, tuck the right knee onto the floor behind and land sitting on our bums. You might need to watch that through before having a go. If it's the first time you've done it, once you've done it once, you'll be able to, you'll know what's going on. So here we've got our right knee on the our right leg on the floor with the knee pointing directly in front of us. Then we've got our left foot on the outside of the right knee. I'll show you from the front. So right knee on the floor, left leg over. And then we're all going to bring our right hands all the way up to the sky. Both bum cheeks should be firmly rooted on the floor. And then we're just going to hook our right elbow around our left knee and use it to create pressure to create a twist here in the spine and gazing over your left shoulder. And coming through heart center. Now we're going to do a little funky twist. So to do this, you need to keep your feet exactly where they are. So your feet are the only thing that doesn't move right now, and you're going to twizzle all the way around to the right. Yeah, so I'll show you. So keep, use your hands to push off, twizzle, 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 and you should land in exactly the same position, just the other way around. So this time, your right leg is left leg is on the mat, knee directly pointing forward. Your right knee is coming over, sitting next to the left knee, and then both bum cheeks sitting firmly on the floor, lifting our left arm all the way up to the sky, and then bringing it over the right leg and using it to twist firmly and opening up the spine, gazing over the right shoulder. Now we're going to come back up to those standing postures on the other leg. So you stay where you are, I'm just going to move to the front of the mat. So this time our right foot is the one we're coming up onto, so that's not going to move. So we're going to just shift forward. You can use our hands here to push up, push through the right leg, lift the left leg up and bring our hands to heart center, and we should come into warrior three. You can reach our hands forward here, coming into one straight line, flexing the left toes. Now we're going to come up to our dancer posture. So we're going to bend slightly through the right knee. We're going to bend the left leg and catch the left leg with our left hand and push up into that hand. Woo, try not to fall over. If you do, just come back into it and gazing over the right fingertips. Now we're going to slightly bend through the right knee as we bring the left knee through in front of us. Bring our hands all the way up to the sky and hold here and lower. Oh, well done. That was quite a tricky sequence. Maybe if you can catch it through the first time, just rewind and do it again and you'll be able to pick it up pretty easily. So now we're going to bring our toes together, heels slightly apart. Inhale, hands up to the sky. And then we're just going to step our right leg back into a warrior two position again. Opening up our arms, gazing over the left hand. Now we're all going to straighten that front leg and just raise up, release our warriors. And then coming straight back into it. And then releasing our warriors. And coming back in. And one last time, releasing our warriors. And then we're gonna swivel our hands to the front of the mat. And here, we're this is quite a tricky posture, so just come to wherever you can. And so we're gonna lift, push through. All our weight's going to go into our right hand and right foot. So we're going to lift up the left leg as we flip it over behind, and we're turning our bodies over until our left hand eventually will come off the mat. This might be where you are today, and that's absolutely fine. It's still super strong posture. If your foot touches the back of the floor behind you, then place it down and just use this to push your hips up and come into wild thing. And then coming back around with control, bring our left hand down to the mat, coming into this weird plank position, and then we're going to bring our left knee to our chest again, pull it, bring it through our bodies to put over to our right hand, and coming into this star position that we did at the beginning of the practice, and just opening up the right hand to the sky. And then we're just gonna, so I'm gonna turn around and face you so you can see me. And we're all just gonna bring our hands up to the sky, and then bring our left hand in front of our right inner thigh, and just sweep over to the left. Just come to wherever your body will allow you today. So that might be here. You might be able to grab the toes. If you can, then use that as a leverage to twist your body up open to the sky. And come up, and now we see the other side. So pushing the right leg against the inside of the left thigh. Again, opening up the left arm, swooping it over. You might come to here. Again, that's absolutely fine. Or grabbing the toes and using this as leverage to twizzle your heart up open to the sky and smile. And then coming up. Now we're going to come to right side pigeon. So this means we need to swivel our hips around a little bit, bend the front knee in, and come into pigeon. So you want your right foot to be coming close to the left thigh. We'll start with an active pigeon. I'm just going to put this on because it's suddenly got freezing. And just coming to wherever you can today in this posture. If you have a block, then maybe using the block to put under your right bum bone. This will just make you a bit more balanced. And then lowering down to the mat, placing the hands on the floor and putting our foreheads onto our hands, and just resting here a moment. Just really feel the opening of the right hip. And then everyone coming up. Tuck under the back toes. Coming into a three-legged dog, maybe shaking out that leg. And then lower it down into a downward facing dog. Now we're all going to bend our knees here, and we're going to meet at the top of the mat. Coming into a halfway lift. Forward fold. And then coming up to standing. Head and neck coming last. Now we've got to do that all on the other side. So, toes touching, heels slightly apart. Inhale, hands up to the sky. Bringing that left leg up and opening up into a warrior two position. Really pushing into this front knee
opening up those hip flexors a little bit more this time. And then release the warrior. Come into our warrior twos. And release the warrior. And again, coming into our warrior two. And release. And one last time, warrior two.
Wimble our hands round to the front of the mat. And again, we're going to come into this wild thing. So remember, picking up the right foot this time, putting all our weight into our left hand and left foot, twisting over like we're coming into side plank. Maybe this is where you come to today. Again, absolutely fine, super strong posture. If you can, bring your right foot to the mat, use your hips as a leverage, push through that foot and open up into a wild thing. Then coming back through, placing the right hand onto the mat, twisting that right foot through the body and opening up into our star. Then hopefully more gracefully this time, we'll come down into a wide-legged forward fold. And then we'll all just lean forward, opening up through the hips. Either coming just here, that's fine. If you have a block, maybe using the block to put your elbows on, or resting your elbows on the floor. If you can, you can bring your hands to touch your toes and just use this as a leverage to get your face closer to the ground. If you can touch the ground, I want you to just bring yourself slightly off, because this isn't making you any stronger. You're just falling into a position. So we want to work on the mobility here. So holding yourself a little bit further off the ground is going to be much more beneficial to you. And everyone coming up. Now we need to do pigeon on the left side. So again, flipping the back, the right leg around, and then tucking the left leg in. Bringing your left foot to meet the right thigh. And again, maybe using a block to put under the left bum cheek, just to give you a little bit, make it a little bit more comfortable to stay in for a long time, because this posture can be quite tricky if you're quite tight in those areas. And then lowering down, bringing our foreheads to our back of our hands to use as a pillow, as we just breathe into this position, maybe getting a little bit deeper with each inhale. Everyone pushing up onto their hands, coming back into that three-leg dog, maybe giving that leg a little bit of a shake before facing it down into downward facing dog. And then we're all going to bend our knees and come through to seated, however you please to get there. And then we're just going to bring our legs out in front of us. And we're going to do a forward fold, but we're going to bring that movement back into it. So we're going to sweep forward and up and open to cactus. And sweep forward and up and open to cactus. And sweep forward. Hopefully with each forward movement you're getting a little bit deeper into the pose. And then this time, taking it all the way down. You might need to bend your knees here to be able to clasp your toes, that's absolutely fine. Just remembering to elongate the spine rather than hunching around. Maybe closing off the eyes, starting to take the gaze inwards. And just noticing how you feel. And then everyone coming up. We're going to just lie on our backs here and just bring your knees into your chest and give yourself a hug, maybe rocking from side to side. And then I'm going to rock up again to seated and do one last little core exercise. So we're coming into boat pose here, so arms out in front of you. And again, we're just going to move with the movement. So we're going to just however you please, just moving your legs in and out. Just whatever feels nice to you today. I prefer doing this with movement as it distracts me of what is actually going on. One last movement. And then lowering all the way down to the mat into our final relaxation. Savasana. So on our heels placed on the mat, our toes falling out to the sides, our hands down beside us, palms facing up to the sky, receiving all that good energy, tucking our chins slightly to our chest, making sure every single muscle in our body is relaxing now. Even our face and our jaw, as we often hold a lot of tension there without really realizing. And just breathe. If you have time, then I would recommend staying here longer, but I'm going to start to bring the practice to a close here now. So if you are going to stay, just press pause and come back to your relaxation. If you're finishing with me, then start to wiggle your fingers and your toes, moving your head from left to right. Lifting the left leg into the body and the right, and just giving yourself a hug again, maybe rocking from left to right. gently falling onto one side,
using your arm as a pillow. Keeping your eyes closed here, we're going to push up to a seated posture, whichever one you choose to do. Now we're all going to bring our hands up to the sky and inhale. Exhale through heart center. Namaste. Thank you everyone for flowing with me. Some of the postures in there might have been new to you, so it might have seemed really tricky this time, but the next time you do it, your body will remember the poses that you've done and it will get easier with time. It was just one to have a bit of fun with, and yeah, hope to see you all soon. Have a lovely day. Bye.